Welcome all of you students. Now I am going to start the unit number 4, Chemical Bonding and Catalysis. Lecture number 1, Basic Science, Chemistry, Course Code 22102 for all first year diploma program, first semester I skip. Now myself, Mr. M.L. Ahir, lecturer in chemistry. Now, the basic science are divided into the two part. The one is a basic physics and another is a basic chemistry. The syllabus for the basic science is available in a combined state or combined of both, that is physics and chemistry. In the syllabus, that is a 4th, 5th and 6th units are basic chemistry, and basic chemistry unit wise allocated hours and marks are as below. The unit 4, chemical bonding and catalysis, these topic allotted 8 hours and 9 marks. Unit number 5, metal corrosion, its prevention and electrochemistry, it provide the 12 hours and 12 marks. Now, the unit number 6, paint varnish, insulator, polymer adhesive lubricant, these topics provided the 12 hours and 14 marks. Okay, the total hours are provided in our curriculum, that is 32 hours for basic chemistry and 35 marks, total 35 marks. The detailed syllabus are available on the MSBT website, msbt.org.in, and links are to be provided here, that is msbt.org.in portal, MSBT file, curriculum search, paper code file 22102. Okay, now I am going to start the first unit, that is 4th unit, chemical bonding and catalysis. These units provided the 8 hours and 9 marks. Now, the first chemical bonding. Now, see the first chemical bonding. The previously, now all of you know the atomicity. Now, see the one example, that is a mol. Molecules of inert gases or elements of inert gases, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, this consist of only one atom, hence these elements are known as the monoatomic. Most of the metal and non-metals contain only one atom in their molecules, and hence these are also known as the monoatomic. But the some examples like gases, that is hydrogen, chlorine, nitrogen, oxygen, etc., these molecules containing the two atoms, and therefore it is called as a diatom. The examples of ozone, water molecules, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, these molecules containing the three atoms. This is called as the triatomic. That is a concept of atomicity. Means atomicity is defined as the number of atoms present in the molecules of an element. Atomicity are of, that is a monoatomic, diatomic and triatomic. Okay, now the chemical bonding, the chemical bond is formed due to the force of attraction between atoms to hold them together by the stable molecules. Okay, for example, water. The water is a molecule, and in between the water, that is a bond is formed that is hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, oxygen, these bonds are known as the chemical bond. O2 molecules, that is the formation of chemical bond in between the oxygen-oxygen atom. At the time of chemical bond formation or chemical combination, that is formation of chemical bond, and these bonds are of two types. One is the primary bond and second is the secondary bond. The primary bond, for example, ionic bond, covalent bond, coordinate bond, metallic bond, etc. And secondary bond, generally these are the weak bond, also exist either within the same molecule or between the neighboring molecules, known as van der Waal force of attraction and hydrogen bond. The basically the chemical properties of any compounds or any molecules is depends upon the primary bond, and physical properties are depends upon the chemical bond. Okay, are the chemical bond. Now next one, the electronic theory of valency. The electronic theory of valency is related to the stable electronic configuration, and this theory is put forward by Kossel and Lewis in 1916, but it is implemented by the Langmuir in 1990. According to this theory, the every element has a tendency to occupy inert electronic configuration of the nearest inert gas, because it is considered as the most stable electronic configuration, that is a stable octet. The characteristics or silent feature of electronic theory of valency. The silent feature of electronic theory of valency, the first one, that is a valency electron. The valency electron means the electrons present in outermost orbit of an atom determine the valency. Electrons present in outermost orbit of an atom determine the valency of an atom, and hence these are called as a valency electron. Okay, now the atom of an element with 8 electrons in outermost orbit, or two electrons in their outermost orbit or shell, these atoms are considered as a stable, and it is known as the stable electronic configuration. Okay, now, those elements having less than 8 electrons in their outermost shell out of their atom are capable to chemical combination, and such elements are active or unstable elements. That is, active or unstable elements, these are the important word, and so that they may also acquire the stable inert gas configuration with 8 electron in the outermost shell. Okay, and these active or unstable elements, it is take part in the chemical combination. Now the octet or duplet, these are the octet rule or duplet rule. The octet rule means the tendency of an atom acquire the 8 electrons in their outermost shell are known as octet rule. Duplet rule, the tendency of an atom acquire the 2 electrons in their outermost orbit or shell are known as the duplet rule. The octet or duplet can achieve either by loss or gain of electron from the atom of one element to another element by sharing of electron between the atom. At the time of losing or gaining the electron or sharing the electron, that is formation of chemical combination, and at the time of the chemical combination, that is a form the chemical bond. And these chemical bonds are of different types. Okay, the first one is the ionic bond, that is known as the electrovalent bond, covalent bond, coordinate bond, metallic bond, hydrogen bond, and van der Waal or intermolecular force of attraction. Such types of bonding are to be formed, that is a different modes of chemical combination. Different modes of chemical combination. And basically, the valency electrons are take part in, valency electrons are responsible for the formation of chemical bond. Okay? Thank you, students.